Hello dear students, in this session we will learn how to derive an expression for centripetal acceleration as given in NCERT, because sometimes most of the students feel difficulty in deriving that derivation because some vector concept is involved, okay. Two, three concepts are mixed there. Actually the derivation is very simple, we will see how it is, okay. Let us consider a body moving in a circular path. Say this is the center of the circle C, okay, and this is the sense of motion, sense of revolution of the particle, okay. The particle is moving like this. Say at some time t is equal to 0, okay, the particle is at point P, okay, and the corresponding position vector of the particle, let it be r. After some time the particle is at point P prime, we will say this is point P prime, okay. The corresponding position vector, let it be r prime, okay. When the particle is at point P, the velocity is, let it be v, velocity is v. When the particle is at point P prime, say the velocity is v prime. Okay. When the particle is at point P, position vector is r, corresponding velocity is v. When the particle is at point P prime, the position vector is r prime and the corresponding velocity is v prime. So, the angular displacement, let it be delta theta. Now, what is the displacement vector? Initially the particle was here, finally the particle is here. This is the displacement vector delta r. R displacement means what? See, if you use the triangle law of vector addition, how you can write? So, r and delta r, these two vectors are in order, r prime is in the opposite order. So, therefore, I can write it as vector r plus delta r is equal to r prime, correct? Now, r prime is equal to r plus delta r. Or can I write r prime minus r is equal to delta r? R prime minus r is equal to delta r. What does it mean? Final position vector, final position minus initial position gives you displacement. This is correct, this is delta r. Now, what we will do? Now, we will bisect this angle delta theta like this. Then what we will do? See, I will move this vector here v, and I will place it somewhere here, okay. This is vector v. I can move vector v freely in space, provided I should not change its magnitude and direction. I can do it. This is v. Now, I will bring this v prime and I will keep it here, okay. This is v prime. You draw the diagram using compass and scale, then you get an exact picture. Then what is this vector? This vector is change in velocity, basically. How we can see using triangle law of vector addition once again. Now see what is v prime using triangle law. Vector v and delta v are in order. V prime is the closing side of the triangle taken in the opposite order. So, therefore, V prime is equal to V plus delta V, or final velocity. See, this is initial velocity, this is final velocity, correct? Now, final velocity minus initial velocity is equal to delta V. What is final velocity minus initial velocity? Change in velocity. So, this is change in velocity. And one more thing what we know is, one more thing that is very important is, what is acceleration? Acceleration is equal to rate of change of velocity, delta v by delta t, correct? Na? Average acceleration is delta v by delta t, delta t. Delta t is a scalar. So, what is the direction of acceleration? Direction of acceleration will be direction of change in velocity, correct? Na? Here, what is the direction of change in velocity? direction of change in velocity is towards the center along the radius. So it is towards the center, center seeking. Okay. So therefore, acceleration also should be towards the center. That is why we call it a centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration means that is towards the center. This angle also will be equal to delta theta. Okay. Why? Say, I have two vectors. Say I have two vectors, vector A, okay, and vector B. Angle between these two vectors, let it be 30 degree. Now, let me draw a perpendicular to vector A, say that is P, and let me draw a perpendicular to vector B, say that is Q. Now, what is the angle between P and Q? Say P, I'll write it here. Now, what is the angle between P and Q? That also should be 90 degree. Okay. See here, vector R was there, that is like vector A. R prime is like vector B. V is perpendicular to R, P is perpendicular to A. V prime is perpendicular to R prime. Q is perpendicular to B. Okay. So, therefore, see there. Angle between A and B equal to angle between P and Q. So, similarly here, angle between R and R prime is equal to angle between V and V prime. So, therefore, this is delta theta. If those two angles are same, then these two triangles are similar triangles. Okay. These two triangles are similar triangles. I will name this triangle as some G, H, I. Okay, G, H, I. Now, in the case of similar triangles, ratio of sides you can compare. Okay. How to choose sides? Say for example, in this triangle C, P, P prime, for delta theta, with respect to delta theta, delta R is the opposite side. Delta R, let me consider. Delta R is the magnitude of vector delta R. Delta R by R, go in cyclic order. Delta R by R is equal to, here opposite side to what is delta theta is delta V. Again go in cyclic order, delta V by V, delta V by V. Identified the opposite side, then go in cyclic order. Okay, delta R by R is equal to delta V by V, or I can write an equation for delta V. Delta V is equal to V by R into delta R, V by R. Now, what is the equation for acceleration? Instantaneous acceleration is equal to, okay. What is average acceleration? Average acceleration is delta V by delta T. Okay. Limiting value of average acceleration, limit delta T tends to 0, delta V by delta T is instantaneous acceleration. Now, I know the equation for delta V, let me substitute. Okay. But here in this equation, V and R, now here the body is moving with a constant speed, na? Say the body is moving with a constant speed, okay. So uniform circular motion. So derivation expression for centripetal acceleration, okay. And this situation considered here V is uniform circular motion. So what do you mean by uniform circular motion? The body is moving in a circular path with a constant speed. So, speed is constant here in this situation. Speed is constant. Speed is constant. Okay. Speed means magnitude of velocity. So, magnitude of this, length of this and length of this both are same. And R means radius of the circular path, that is also constant. So, I can't, they are not dependent on time. So, I cannot apply limit to V and R. So, V and R I will write outside into delta R by delta T as limit delta T tends to 0. What I have done? Here I should have written, in the place of delta T, I should have written this. But I have taken V and R outside because they are independent of time. Now, what is limit, what is delta R by delta T in that diagram? Delta R means displacement vector. Displacement by time is velocity, correct now, velocity. But if you consider a very small time interval, Okay, if you consider a very small time interval, say t is equal to 0, particle is at p. If you consider a very small time interval, say this is p prime, then what happens? So, this will be the distance and this will be the displacement. There will not be any difference between displacement and distance. Now, in this situation, t is equal to 0, particle is here, after some time a particle is here. This is the distance and this is the displacement, they are not equal. But if you reduce the time interval, when you reduce the time interval, say this will become p prime, correct na? Then displacement and distance, they are almost equal, they are equal. Okay. So, what I can do, when the time interval tends to 0, delta r by delta t becomes speed. Okay, this will be equal to speed. Okay, because displacement becomes equal to distance. Distance by time is speed. So, v into v, v square by 4. Therefore, expression for centripetal acceleration is equal to v square by r. Centripetal acceleration is given by v square by r. In one of the previous sessions, I have explained, I have given the relation between v and r. We know that v is equal to omega r. If I substitute this equation here, what happens? Centripetal acceleration is equal to v square. V square means omega square r square divided by r. 1 r, r gets cancelled. Expression for centripetal acceleration will be omega square r. Centripetal acceleration is equal to omega square r. Hope you have understood it.